really the stair, it goes along level and then it zooms up. Wouldn't it be kind of cool if we could make that molding curve instead? Let's think about how we'd do that. First of all, I'm going to get a piece of wood and I'm going to cut it to set the saw on 53 and cut it because I know that'll fit right in there. Going to duplicate actual job site conditions here and have big piles of scraps everywhere. I usually carry a little notebook with me, like a composition book, and I write these different dimensions down in it, or otherwise I'll forget them. You know what they say about dimensions is you're not supposed to remember them, you're supposed to forget them as soon as you cut them. You'll see what I'm getting at in a moment here. Saw isn't quite long enough to cut this whole cross cut of this 1x10. Okay, so this piece will go right in there. Now I want to cut it to a curve. Well, I want as big a curve as I can because I don't want to make a little tight curve. I have a pair of dividers and I could turn a little short curve, but I'm going to have a hard time bending a molding into a tight radius. I want to cut a curve that's as long as this. And it would probably be, when I look at the curve, it would probably be like an 8-foot radius, so I don't want to do that. So I'm going to draw the curve another way. I thought I might be able to put this up on the easel and do it, so let's see if that works. Because normally I do this kneeling on the floor or on the table, but let's do it where you can see it. I'm going to take my Sharpie just to make it easier for you to see. I'd normally do this with a pencil. And that's 15 inches. So I'm going to make a mark every 2 inches down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'll go every 2 inches along here, too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I'm going to number them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Anybody getting a method to my madness here yet? I'm going to connect 1 and 1 right here. And I'm going to connect 2 and 2. And I'm going to connect 3 and 3. You get the idea. I have to number them because it's easy to get confused otherwise. Or maybe it's not that easy. Easy for me, though. So there's a nice smooth curve. Now, if we were on a real job site here, I'd probably get my sandpaper block and I'd fair this curve a little bit, and I would absolutely definitely put some glue here. A regular woodworking glue is good, you know, tight bond. I like tight bond 3 is a good glue. And I can nail this on. And there's a curve. And I found that PVC molding, AZAC, Versatech, those moldings are actually amazingly flexible. And you can actually buy a nice selection of moldings from this material. And it'll bend right in here. And if it won't bend easily, you can put it out in the sun on a hot day. It'll make it quite a bit more flexible. We actually have a heat blanket that we use. And we can tie it into a knot. So that's kind of a stylish look. And we could go the same way on the top. We could connect this and this and draw a series of lines before we nail these guys in. And we could have made a curve here and bent it the other way. And if you look at old work, that's amazingly common to see that little detail.